In this video, we will explain how to check for shorts and faults on the Rebus wiring. Rebus is responsible for system power transmission and device communication. The Rebus nanogrid operates between 380 and 420 volts DC and is produced by the inverter power core. Each Rebus device will connect to the inverter's bidirectional DC terminal with a positive and negative conductor. To prevent meter damage while measuring resistance, first perform a voltage test to ensure no voltage is present. Rebus devices are bonded to the ground terminal in the inverter. Ensure all PowerCell DC disconnects are off. All Rebus checks must be performed prior to energizing the system. Also ensure all DC connections are secure from inverter to Rebus devices. With the multimeter set to resistance, place probes on the RE positive and the RE negative for a set of DC terminals. This value should be greater than 10 kiloohms or should display OL, open line. Repeat for each DC circuit in use. Place one probe on the grounding bar and the other to RE positive on a DC terminal. This value should also be greater than 10 kiloohms or should display OL. Repeat this process for each RE positive to ground and then for each RE negative to ground. If the measured resistance values indicate a short or fault, confirm that conductor connections are landed as to not touch each other. Also, inspect that conductors are free of nicks or breaks. Now that all Rebus conductors are free of shorts and faults, we can continue with the commissioning process and the AC side of the system. See the links in the video description below to access more video resources and to enroll in the PowerCell Sales and Installation course. Completing the course will give dealers access to claim warranty compensation as well as advanced technical support.